Marhaba from the UAE. I'm Gina Fernandez. I'm an artist, marketing art director, and an educator for SDGs. I think everyone today worries about climate injustice. It is overwhelming. So I had to journey through understanding that it is the little things that matter. As an artist, I realized what a big impact art has. Pictures speak more than words. I started by giving many education talks on the shocking Great Pacific Garbage Patch pollution, the hundreds of whales and marine life washing ashore because of the plastic they consumed or entangled in abandoned fishing nets. I decided to do an informal art session with about 300 third graders in my son's school. I gave them a task to collect whatever bottle caps they could find at home and at school. In 2 weeks, we collected 5,000 plastic bottle caps. With that, I took the children outdoor and conducted an art workshop and shared incidents of the ocean creatures who are suffering because of our behavior and consumption. Together, we created a mural of a beached whale. Towards the end of the project, I realized that the mentors of the school, parents, and the staff too joined in to finish the mural. And together we pledged to say no to plastic. Inspired by the response I was getting, I decided to scale up my fight against single-use waste. I approached many organizations, schools, establishments, and that marked the birth of our project, Sustainable Brands. I realized it's much harder to make sustainable choices in urban spaces, such as Dubai, with the amount of single-use plastic we have access to. We tend to ignore our conscience and thus blame it on our fast-paced life. That's where we step in. We not just help individuals, we educate them. We not just help corporates and establishments, we educate them. And we help them to shift to making sustainable choices every day. I'd like to share about my next project, Tiddy the Turtle. It's amazing how children are the ones who care so much about what they see. So this is how it all began. Our friend's daughter approached me to help her on a beach cleanup. I assured her that we would find no garbage. Surely we didn't find any visible garbage, but what we did find was hundreds of cigarette butts littered on the beach. On that day, the seven of us each collected a bag full of cigarette butts in just about 40 minutes over a span of about 500 meter radius. But what we did was we saw a lot more, and that really troubled me. One might imagine, what harm does littering cigarette butts do to the planet? The fact is that besides the thousands of chemicals that get released in the air when lit, and besides the carcinogens one intakes, the cigarette filters contain a type of plastic called cellulose acetate. So I was curious. I conducted a survey to question why most smokers litter. A smoker feels that the butt gets buried under the sand will biodegrade. But the nature of the sand is that it does not sit still. Mostly due to wind, toxic cigarette butts land in the ocean and is mistaken as food by birds and sea creatures. Cigarette butts just as single-use plastic in the ocean is mistaken for food and is ingested by animals. Now, for days and days, the visuals of the cigarette butts did not leave my mind. With the help of our local municipality and about 60 friends, we came back later and together we collected about 30,000 cigarette butts and about 15 kgs of single-use plastic. Mind you, during a span of just 1 hour, within a radius of 500 meters. At this moment, remembering what the plastic bottle cap whale had, I decided to put my artivist hat on. And I did a hands-on art workshop on the beach. We created a 3D sculpture of a turtle out of the cigarette butts gathered, and we decided to call her Tilly the Turtle. This was a tradition that followed after every beach cleanup we did. The students who joined the cleanups approached me so that they could adopt it by taking it to their school towards climate action and conserving life below water. They shared their discoveries with their school principals, mentors, and everybody in school. And thus, Tilly became an educational tool for the Global Goals SDG 14, Life Below Water. And together with the community, we collected over 3 million cigarette butts and over 500 kgs of plastic and other rubbish with so many amazing people and especially students since 2017. We have educated thousands of amazing people, especially children, and I've created at least 14 mascots of Tilly the Turtle that have been adopted not just by schools but by establishments. Tilly is now adopted in 9 schools in Dubai, 1 school in Romania, 2 corporates in Dubai, is gifted to an ocean activist, and the Global Goals World Cup team in Copenhagen. A whole new universe began to develop around Tilly wherever she went. She travels from kindergarten to higher secondary. The students began their activism in different unique ways, such as school assemblies, group discussions, creative art studies, theater performance, paintings, posters, writing stories, making slogans, organizing theme sport events, sustainability school project, visit to turtle rehabilitation centers, name it. They did everything they could to spread the word towards conservation for the oceans. And the amazing thing is that the journey Tilly the Turtle went on with our project Sustainable Brands. Tilly became a permanent exhibit in schools, a mascot for the 2018 Global Goals World Cup in Dubai. She was invited to exhibitions and student-led SDGs learning markets. She went on radio, on the local newspaper. The 15th mascot of Tilly the Turtle is perhaps my most favorite of all. They were created by my sons with their little hands when they were just about 8 and 4 years old. They did an experiment to see how many cigarette butts are littered around our community. In 30 minutes, they collected over 300 cigarette butts and were sad to see that not just ocean life, but even birds fall prey to the butts, mistaking it for food. They spoke to the community about the litter issue. But what they also did was create a tiny Tilly the Turtle made out of the cigarette butts collected. And they sent it to the Vatican for His Holiness Pope Francis. My older son wrote a heartfelt letter sharing about how they were inspired to create their own Tilly the Turtle, and also share about the ill effects on littering in the ocean that harm sea animals and other creatures. Truly, children watch and learn. Later, the Vatican newspaper also mirrored our thoughts. Now, as I look back on my journey, I remember how I wanted to change and save the world all by myself. But I realize now that it is the smallest actions that make a difference. And I want you to all also realize that it is the smallest actions that makes the biggest difference. And it is the smallest actions that will inspire others. And as the late Judge Ruth Bader Ginsburg said, fight for the things that you care about the most, but do it in a way that will lead others to join you. On this note, I'd like to say bye and thank you very much. I hope Tilly inspires you to do many things.